Behind the scenes look at the way we do things here at Good Shepherd. I'm Father Miller, for those of you who don't know me, and I'll be guiding you through this tour of the sacristy. Now, have you guys ever asked yourselves, what is a sacristy? What are sacristans? Well, you guys know that preparation for Mass is a crucial part of our day, right? Because that's like the source and summit of everything we do in the day. That's why we start our day with Mass. That's why we're streaming it. So there's actually a step before Mass gets started, and that takes place in the sacristy. And it's done by sacristans, the people who prepare for Mass. So we're going to take a brief look at the tools that sacristans use, the main tools that the sacristans use to set up for Mass. And, you know, it's actually a lot more cumbersome to explain the whole sacristy in a 4-minute short, but hey, we're going to try for 4 minutes. Move the camera here and give you guys a good look at what we got going on back here. Okay, so along this counter is everything that we need to say Mass and all the tools that sacristans prepare for. So all of this is pretty much essential. And we'll start with the most essential, and that's the chalice. The chalice has got several different things attached onto it. And we've got all these different things that, you know, they look complicated, but they're actually very simple. The first thing that you put on the chalice is the purificator. The purificator is what catches the precious drops of our Lord's blood. You know, once the priest is done consuming the chalice, this is what he uses. And that's the first thing that goes on top of the chalice. This is a paten with a host on it, the bigger celebrant's host. And that's on top of the paten. The paten is used to kind of support the host, and it's made of brass, just like the chalice is made of brass. These things are precious metals, and that's why we use it, because our Lord is precious, and we put him in something precious, and support him in something precious. This is called the pall, that protects the host. You know, in cathedrals and stuff, they used to have, like, you know, you probably have to worry about birds swooping down, so, like, there's some cathedrals still today, but hey, and then this is the corporal. This is the first thing that comes off the chalice, and it's the last thing that goes on. And this, the corporal, that big, long linen, is used to catch particles of our Lord that might fall from the paten. And then, of course, you guys are all familiar with the ciboria, which holds the unconsecrated hosts, and it's empty right now, but yeah. So sacristans are all in charge of preparing this stuff. And obviously the wine and the water, what you need for the precious blood, and then the water for the commingling. And then this is called, it's a lavabo dish with a lot, I don't know, this is the lavabo and that's the dish. With a finger towel for the priest to purify his hands. All of this stuff gets put on the tray, and you'll see the altar server's carrying the tray outside and taking it to the back. This is where we keep the hosts, and you know this is all put out. And if we don't have one of these things, you know, it all of a sudden Mass becomes a lot messier. So let me show you what a complete tray looks like. So here we have the complete set. Father Sullivan's chalice, which you guys see at Mass, is completely set, ready to go. The lavabo dish there on the side to the left, and then the wine and the water right there. And that's the complete thing. That's the main thing sacristans do. And for Mass and stuff, you know, like it looks a little more complicated. It seems like it's a bigger production, but it's actually very simple. So that's what basically sacristans do to set up. And in the sacristy, going back in real briefly. So, and this is just where we clean up the sink. And then this sacred spot is called the sacrarium. That's where it goes straight down into the earth, just in case we have any, like, particles or anything that we miss, you know. Everything is to, you know, protect the sacredness of our Lord and the precious body and blood. So, I mean, that's, you know, overview, basic overview of our sacristy And everything, like, you in these drawers and stuff, that's where all those linens are, except for maybe, like, you know, the precious metals and stuff. So I hope this has been informative. Thank you guys so much for watching, and see you for the next Behind the Scenes segment. God bless.
Sunday of Easter, but also on this Mother's Day. And so we celebrate today the gift of life and how it is shared with us, given to us through our mothers. As we celebrate today, also in this month of May, we honor Mary, who is the mother of us all. And during this Mass, we'll have a very special May crowning to honor Mary as not only Queen of Heaven and Earth, but also the Queen of our hearts. And so, dear friends, as we gather today, no matter where we are, how we're joined, who we are, where we're from, we're so glad we're able to celebrate this Mass together as we now call upon God's mercy. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Thank you.
Almighty, ever-living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those you were pleased to make new in holy baptism may, under your protective care, bear much fruit and come to the joys of eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. As the number of disciples continued to grow, the Hellenists complained against the Hebrews because their widows were being neglected in the daily distribution. So the 12 called together the community of the disciples and said, "It is not right for us to neglect the word of God to serve a table. Brothers, select from among you 7 reputable men, filled with the Spirit and wisdom, whom we shall appoint to this task, whereas we shall devote ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word." The proposal was accepted to the whole community, so they chose Stephen, a man filled with faith and the Holy Spirit, also Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas of Antioch, a convert to Judaism. They presented these men to the apostles, who prayed and laid hands on them. The word of God continued to spread, and the number of the disciples in Jerusalem increased greatly. Even a large number of priests were becoming obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, come to him, a living stone, rejected by human beings, but chosen and precious in the sight of God. And, like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it says in Scripture, Behold, I am laying a stone in Zion, a cornerstone chosen and precious, and whoever believes in it shall not be put to shame. Therefore, its value is for you who have faith, but not for those without faith. The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, and a stone that will make people stumble, and a rock that will make them fall. They stumble by disobeying the word, as is their destiny. You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people of its own, so that you may announce the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Jesus said to his disciples, Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you may also be. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said to him, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Philip said to him, Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us. Jesus said to him, Have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, Show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing his works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me, or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than these, because I am going to the Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today in the Gospel, we hear those incredible words that really bring us soothing and peace and comfort and hope. Jesus says, do not let your hearts be troubled. Do not let your hearts be troubled. And I think that when our hearts are troubled, even as a small infant and even as an adult, no matter what our age, the one who is able to hear on earth in many ways to give us comfort, to make us peaceful, to give us assurance, to let our hearts not be troubled, are our mothers. And so today we honor all mothers who really are that kind of link for us, the first teachers of our ways of faith, and that are always drawing us to Jesus in one way or another. The vocation of a mother is to love her child, to make sure her child has what that child needs, to grow, to mature, to be happy, and to be holy, to be healthy. Ultimately, a parent's vocation is to make sure that their child has the tools and the experiences to get to heaven, to be happy in this life, but also then to be able to get to the life that is to come. And so today we honor all mothers, but we look especially to Mary, the mother of us all, who Jesus gave to us as our mother. And she really, as Jesus says, he is the way, the truth, and the life, constantly is pointing us to him. It's been said, if you want to know Jesus, then stay close to his mother, because Mary always leads us to Jesus, always directs us to her son. She is the first of the disciples in a very real way. And we think about that way, the truth, and the life. Certainly the life. Her yes, through her then, yes, God brought his son into the world. And life was given, and life restored. The truth. Mary knows the truth. Mary does not go to the grave on Easter Sunday morning, because she knew that her son would not be there. She believed the truth that he spoke. And she is also then the way, shows us the way, redirects us, just as a mother helps us find our path through life, will guide us by our hand through a crowded store, or hold our hand as we go to that first day of school to show us the way. Mary shows us the way as well. This blessed mother who we have in heaven, holding us by the hand and connecting us then to her son. So Mary truly is the queen of the world, the queen of heaven and of earth, but also the queen of our hearts. And it's a tradition in our faith to crown Mary then queen during May, to have what is called a May crowning. And we do that today. And we have some very special friends with us this morning who are going to crown Mary for us. Their hands, as they place the crown on Mary's head, represent all of us as we give ourselves to Mary to lead us to her son. And we're glad this morning, you know that Brian Pritchard has been our camera person and technician back here for every broadcast mass that we've done over the last 8 weeks. And so we wanted to make it possible for him to be with his family, with his wife Samantha and their children today on Mother's Day for mass. And so his daughter and son, Mia and Ryan, will crown Our Lady today. And we also give a special hello and shout out to Nicholas, who is watching from home, and Sam and Brian's other children, as today for us, they crown Mary with love, with honor, with respect, asking her for protection, and to be the model of our hope during this time. Let us profess the faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven.
And by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man.
For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Confident that our faith in God will never disappoint us, let us make our prayers known to the Father in Jesus' name.
Our response is, Risen Lord, we trust in you. For bishops, priests, deacons, religious, and lay leaders of our church, that they may be dedicated to prayer and the ministry of the word, let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, we trust in you.
For leaders of nations, may their decisions be guided by care for the most vulnerable with their societies, especially the elderly and the orphan, let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, we trust in you.
For the gift of motherhood, that all might treasure and support God's plan for life and love, let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, we trust in you.
For the sick, the suffering, the alone, the afraid, and the isolated, for healthcare workers, first responders, researchers, and those who provide life-sustaining services at this time. May they know healing, strength, insight, courage, our support, and God's wisdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, we trust in you.
For all gathered here, may our words and actions testify to Jesus, the way, the truth, and the life, and invite others to know and follow him. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, we trust in you.
For the faithful departed, may they know eternal joy in heaven, especially for Thomas Dermott Jr., brother of Maureen Dermott, and Michael Nelson Jr., a parishioner. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, we trust in you.
For all the people and intentions in our minds and hearts today, and especially for Rose Placey, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, we trust in you.
And on this Mother's Day, we ask God's blessing upon all mothers, and especially a special remembrance of our mothers who are already with God in heaven. We pray for all mothers in a special way who have lost a child, those who desire to be mothers, those who have complicated relationships with their mother or children, and for all those who fill a motherly role in our lives. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, we trust in you.
And now we ask God's blessing upon all mothers gathered here in this chapel and gathered around the devices that are joining us via this live stream. Loving God, as a mother gives life and nourishment to her children, so you watch over your church. Bless these women that they may be strengthened as Christian mothers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously. When Christ became our Passover and has been sacrificed, for with the old order restored, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Ronald, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us
this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Before we begin the communion song, we'll now make that act of spiritual communion that's displayed on your screen. graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Again, a very happy and holy and blessed and joyful Mother's Day to all mothers. And so we love you very much, all mothers, and thank you for the gifts, so many gifts, and so much love you pour upon your children. To celebrate Mother's Day, we have muffins for moms at the door to our glass chapel facing Trimble Road, and also then on the entrance to the exterior entrance to the parish office center on the side of the building. And so please stop by and grab some muffins for Mother's Day. Again, thanks to all those who made Mass this morning possible. We're grateful to the Pritchard family for all their hard work. We also apologize for any kind of technical difficulty. I noticed a couple of things that we were having some trouble with our feed this morning, so if that was affecting you, we apologize as we learn this new way of broadcasting and sharing the gospel. Remember that Uncle Paul's food truck, Stuffed Pretzels, will be here on Friday afternoon from 4 to 7. A stuffed pretzel is like a stromboli, but instead of a stromboli, it's a pretzel, almost like a hot pocket with all kinds of great things inside. And so please stop by. They'll be in our parking lot to help provide some food for us and help us share with the local community. Also remember that we'll be back with live from Shepherd for Shepherd Live this Tuesday evening. Hopefully everyone will be working and we'll be back on the air right away this time on Tuesday at 7 p.m. So have a great day. Whatever you're doing, be smart, be safe, be well, be holy, and be at peace. And again, a very happy Mother's Day. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the other evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Have a great day.